Welcome to RPF. In this video, we'll discuss about how to use OpenAI or ChatGPT using Power Automate. So, we'll integrate ChatGPT API with Microsoft Power Automate to search a specific title which we are looking for. So, we'll show you in detail. Now, before proceeding further, let me execute this code and show you how the output looks, and after that I will create the complete flow from scratch. So let's say you are searching for any product informations or any programming language detail. Let's consider Python. So simply write what is Python. Once you'll enter this detail, this will navigate into the ChatGPT applications and extract about Python. So Python is an interpreted high-level general purpose programming language, and then display on message box. We can also store this detail in Excel sheet, which I will cover you in the further part of video. Now after that, we can also call out the status code. Now let's run it again. This time we want to know about what is Microsoft. Now this time it will go to the again API page, search for about Microsoft, and show us the result in message box. So this is how API looks like, where we are extracting the detail based on our requirement. So we'll build this complete flow in front of you so that you'll be able to understand how we can integrate this complete flow from scratch. I'm deleting everything and we'll create it in front of you so that you'll be able to understand how we do it. Before proceeding further, we have to go to beta.openai.com and create account. So as of now, I'm already working on one of the account. From here, you have to just do login, and from there navigate into the documentation sections. Once you'll navigate into the documentation sections, we have to create the API keys. For creation of the API keys, we just need this URL account API keys, and from here we have to create a new secret key. Once we'll create a new secret key, this will showcase us about secret key which we have to copy it. Simply we have to just copy it and paste it to the system. As of now, I don't want, so I'm deleting it. But if you have not created it a secret key, it's always mandatory to create the secret key, which we will use it for integration of Power Automate. After that, when we want to use the code, simply we have to navigate it to the completions create sections. As of now, my requirement is creating or sending a request. So for sending, we have to use either post method or get method. As of now, I want to do write. So here I'm using post, and this is our endpoints. So generally we'll get this endpoint from this website, and this is a format where we can write our text for integrations or creation of post method. Since model is very much required, this is a required field. Other than that, other fields are not a mandatory. So it means model is required. Rest all fields we can keep as per our need. So this is our request and response format, how we will get it. So generally this model works into Power Automate. Let's navigate here. First, I will need input. Input dialog box, which we can send out for the input. So title, as we want to search for something. So here, search from ChatGPT, and input dialog box, please enter your text. Now, default value, I don't want anything. And this is a single line statement. This will create a user input, or maybe we can rename it to user questions. Now click on save and we have this variable created. User. Oh, think we made mistake. User questions. Now we are done. Save it. Next, we want to invoke API. So web services. So for invoking web services, we will need endpoint or end URL, which will copy and paste it from here. Now this is done. For our case, we want to make post. So post method we'll use. As of now, accept is application or XML if you want to use the XML, but we want content type and response as JSON format. So here I made the changes on content type. Custom headers, if we want any custom headers, we will probably keep it. Otherwise, we can just add authentication method. In the authentication method, we'll keep this authentications as per our need. So here for authorization sections, I'm using my past API key, and before adding, we have authorizations add bearer and then API key code, which we will get it the format from here. So this is the proper method which we have to add it over there. Then authentications will be successful. Next item, we want request body. When we want to do the request, simply I will create this request for me and here I will paste it. This is the model which is a required field. Prompt in the user sections, I want to just use the user input entered by custom user. So now we are using this user questions and that's done. Maximum tokens, I'm setting it here 2000, but if you want, you can increase the number. In advanced settings, we have to just disable this code because we don't want an encoded request body, and rest all options will keep similar like it. And it will automatically create a variable for web services response header and web service response. And finally, the status code, which we'll use it in further part of the content. Next, I want to convert this complete text from JSON to custom object. From converting JSON to custom object, we'll use web services response select, and this will create an automatic variable JSON as custom object. Next item, we'll use here display message box. So within the display message box, I will showcase the output. So maybe we'll create it response output. Now this is also the message to display. So what we are looking for, so we want to display this JSON as a custom object, select here, but we don't want everything. But let's save this and run the code, then probably I will explain you how we can extract the exact informations. So we want to just fetch the detail about Java. So I'm writing here what is Java. So this will go to the our API, search for the context, and this will extract it for us. Now you can see we are also getting some JSON format because we don't want this header or anything available. So you can see here choice and text. So and even we have this JSON in the bottom sections as well. But we want detail of choice from the text which is highlighted here. So till here that's fine, but we don't want other things, so we have to modify it into the message box in such a way that should display just as per our requirement. We don't want everything to be covered here so that we will get accurate informations which we are looking for. So for adding this, I will just add square bracket and here I will add choices and then close the square bracket. Generally JSON object is working in the array format, so we'll keep here 0. And finally in the third square bracket, we'll just add text because we are just looking for the text informations, and that's it. We are done. So let's save the to display. Sorry. Text. Okay, there is a typo. Now this is done, and in the second message box we want to just display our status code. So here I will add status code. Now this is done, and in the status code I will just call this value. It's done. So we have integrated here ChatGPT or OpenAI applications with Power Automate and extracting the detail about any specific informations. So let me showcase here what is PHP. So this will go to the ChatGPT, search for this information, extract the detail what we are looking for. So this is just extracted PHP is a server side. There's no JSON code is available. So this is how we can train our informations what we are looking for. And next is showing the status code, that is 200. So this is how we can integrate and search for any specific informations which we are looking from ChatGPT to Power Automate. That's it from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.